We are live from Fist Energy Stadium here in Cleveland, Ohio, home of the Leaveland Burns. Where there's smoke, there's fire, and there's plenty of smoke up here in the booth. We are in for a barn burner today.
Oh, that's coming from the toilets in the men's room. They're on fire again. I'll tell you, this is not an aroma I'm fond of, Grim. Like Olympic cheese fondue gone bad.
Today's matchup promises severed limbs and ruined careers, and lots of beers. The Cardinal Sins go up against the Leaveland Burns. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say. Everyone, Grim Blitzrow with you on MFL Game Day. Hey, Bricks, do you smell something burning?
Thanks for reminding me. I left my rubber foot in the toaster oven to warm it up. Last time I left it there too long, it came out like Saganaki. It's freezing in here.
Hey, why don't you take your shampoo and ouzo, stick your head in the toaster oven, that'll warm you up.
The burn returner was maimed by the opposing team, so it's up to the next man to replace him.
Yeah, what exactly is a burn returner, Grim?
You know, players who catch kickoffs and punts and run them back through the teeth of the defense. They have the lowest survivability rate of any player in the league.
The next man up just sat back down on the bench. He probably cramped his pants.
And it's first and ten.
Yep, third grade. Sister Mary Margaret of Our Ladies of Holy Hell. I thought it was brass knuckles, but it was just a regular knuckles.
Boom, dead and down.
He delivered the freaky fast ham sandwich with extra mustard for the death blow. Speaking of ham sandwiches, I'm gonna go grab one. You want anything?
No, still working on my salami here, Bricks. Thanks.
That's what she said. Didn't work that time. It was close, though.
Yep. And it's first and ten. Oh, great tackle! When his brain is unscrambled, he'll be thinking about that hit.
Yeah, most likely at a convalescent home.
And it's first and ten. Drills one in for the first down. And it's first and ten. Oh, great play. He is on that receiver like glue.
You know, when I was little, my dad used to make me eat glue. My tongue would get stuck to the roof of my mouth, and I couldn't talk.
Your father was a very smart man, Briggs.
Oh, and it eats. Holy crap, he runs straight into a mutant trap and dies. Reminds me of my breakfast cereal, the old Nut Crunch. And here comes the extra point attempt. When you get knocked down, you gotta get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
And it's first and ten. Second down and seven. And that play went nowhere fast. No gain. And that'll bring up third down and seven. Great play by the defense results in an interception. He's leaving a wake of destruction in his path. Caught for the first down. Oh, that was totally uncalled for. And that's why we love the MFL. And it's first and ten. He's leaving a wake of destruction in his path, and the body toll continues to climb. Just keep pounding the ball right up the gut, and you'll tire these guys out.
That's not fair. Someone should call a penalty on this one.
Yeah, the death penalty. Hang them by the nuts.
The offense is running low on running backs. They have only two left. You need to conserve those runners now and consider passing more. First down and long. And they've had enough. The offense jumps on sides and attacks the ref. First down in a mile. And picks up media deuce at most.
Speaking of deuces, I got a... hey, you got a dollar for the bathroom attendant? He threatened me if I didn't tip him next time.
To the races. Third down and six. And he was stuck to him like glue. And they'll line up for the punt here. And he booted a high arcing rainbow. Nice catch, and he turns on the afterburners. Punt returners in this league have a life expectancy of three.
Don't you just love the sound of bones snapping and cracking? I mean, when they're not yowling.
And it's first and ten. Man, what a hit that was.
Yo, seriously, man, you think you can go toe-to-toe with me? I will wreck your world. You understand me, Junior? I'll wreck your world.
Second down and six. And another interception. This quarterback is going to listen to Joy Division. Oh, and he just left an outline on the ground like he was trying to wipe out the dinosaurs.
That must be opposite day because he's the one who just got wiped out.
What are you talking about?
And it's first and ten. And the quarterback throws another pick. He should have eaten his Wheaties this morning. Pow! And how about a little dirt sandwich? And the ref is picking up a wad of singles as he runs off the field.
How do you think he got those, Grim?
Didn't you see him stripping on the sidelines? Yeah. He's bribed, you idiot.
And it's first and goal. Defense says enough of this BS and jumps off sides to lay waste to the referee. Way to go, guys.
Yeah.
And it's first and ten. And the defense. knock the wind out of that quarterback. Second down and a lot. Well, a little chip shot here, extra point, but this guy could blow it. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five. You gotta love a player who goes down fighting. The burn returner was killed on that play. The coach will replace him with another player. And it's first and ten. And the runner is moving crazy fast. Look at the pin. That pass is good for about 5 yards. Second down and five. Boom, dead and down.
He delivered the freaky fast ham sandwich with extra mustard for the death blow. Speaking of ham sandwiches, I'm gonna go grab one. You want anything?
Man, I'm still working on my salami here, Briggs. Thanks.
That's what she said.
Oh, man, he just killed that guy when the play was over.
Well, if the ref didn't see it, at least the mortician did. He's coming out in the field now. And it's first and ten. Second down and long. Wow, the quarterback just threw to his receiver, knocking down. Oh, and the quarterback threads the needle for a first down. First down and nine. I thought the only tie we'd see would be a noose. Instead, they're in a dead heat. Tie game at the end of one. First down and nine. Great play by the defense. It's not too often a quarterback gets rejected.
That's why that's the position I originally tried out for. For other people to accept you.
Now that went from a joke to making me feel feelings. Stop it. This isn't. He might have managed to dig out a yard on that one.
Not my yard. Got too much buried in, you know, the usual money, bodies, coffee cans filled with, well, you know, mostly coffee. Tastes better, like Eskimos burying salmon heads, kimchi, fermented anything, really.
And he catches it for a touchdown. What a beautiful play.
Yeah, it's almost poetic, man.
Okay, nice and easy like a 2-foot putt.
You miss 2-foot putts all the time, Grim.
Straight through the uprights. They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
Thank you. first and 10. Defense goes warp speed. Man, I'm running out of excuses for this kid.
One time when I was playing, a guy hit me so hard, I went into a dark tunnel. Thought I saw my grandparents waving at me in the light. Turns out it was just the visitor's tunnel that he knocked me into, and it was the paramedics waving fingers in my face.
And it's first and 10. And that's a run for no gain.
Then it's not really a run.
Oh, you knew you were going to see a lot of carnage today, folks. These teams have bad blood between them. Apparently, they got it from the same bloodmobile that usually parks outside next to the taco truck. Raccoon rabie blood is my thought. Always a player's favorite. And there's another pick. Man, this quarterback must have learned a lot about shearing when he was in school.
Yeah.
Ouch! What is this, 80s wrestling?
Yeah, you think you can go toe-to-toe with me? Well, you mistaken, man. You get up my grill, I'm gonna ruin your world. I'm gonna wreck it.
And it's first and 10. Second down in a very lot.
It. I had this guy on my fantasy.
Oh, and you can bury that guy because he is dead.
Oh, did you see what number he was? I gotta check it off my dead mutant bingo card. I only need one more.
The offense is down to their last running back. When he bites the dust, they can only pass.
Yeah, well, at least they don't have to forfeit then.
That's right, but now the defense can focus on killing the receivers. And it's first and 10.
Oh, man, he...
Boom! And like the Titanic, his ship just went down.
Hey, I almost got dead mutant bingo. All I need is 77 to bite it.
First down and 1. And that'll be second down and 4. Oh, great throw! Great catch! And that puts 6 points on the board!
The defense can do anything to stop a throw that good, Ben!
You mean aside from priming the ref, killing the quarterback, or actually playing some D?
Don't make any mistakes here, or they'll kick the shit out of you in the locker room. The kick is good! The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
Oh, man, that worm just ate the player alive. You gotta steer clear of the pits.
You know, my sister had a tapeworm almost that big. Name was Frederick. I didn't know that they made great house pets. You just gotta sleep in leather underpants. The little buggers like to burrow.
And it's first and 10. Oh, he almost broke that one wide open.
Hey, speaking of breaking my...
Oh, man, he just killed that guy when the play was over.
Well, if the ref didn't see it, at least the mortician did. He's coming out in the field now. And that'll bring up second and 1. And that's another turnover for the defense. Oh, and he looks like he just saw 400 scary movies after that hit.
Yeah, sounds like my off season.
And it's first and 10. Does the QB know which team he's on?
I don't even know why I'm at.
And he's off to the races. Look at that little mutant run.
I don't think you can say that, Grim.
And it's first and 10. Too many players that kids can look up to at home. I'm glad one guy is still. Oh, and he breaks free and has nothing but open field in front of him. Boom, dead and down. Nothing more to say about this guy except maybe a eulogy.
Well, he was a violent alcoholic, a terrible father, and he did some nasty things to dogs. But, he was a great ball player. That's really what counts at the end of the day, right?
And that'll bring up second and one. Third down and 10. Touchdown! And he rips off a game-breaking run for the score. The offense has only two quarterbacks remaining on the roster. They better be careful because when those guys die, it's forfeit city. Now, there are some who would argue that we should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth 7.
What, and kick the kicker's job in half? They'd just be called sinners then.
Straight through the uprights. They need a good return here to set up the offense. And that's a returnable ball.
Returnable? You mean he can get a refund for it?
No, Bricks. It means he can return it for, and the MFL keeps pounding out the death hits on WMFL 98.8. The greatest hits of all time.
Huh? Did you just say greatest hits? Clap!
The burn returner was maimed by the opposing team, so it's up to the next man to replace him.
Yeah, what exactly is a burn returner, Grim?
Players who catch kickoffs and punts and run them back through the teeth of the defense. They have the lowest survivability rate of any player in the league.
The next man up just sat back down on the bench. He probably cramped his pants.
And it's first and 10. Pass picks up maybe 2 yards. And that'll be second and 8 to go. That's the way to move the chains. That's good for a first down. This game is all about momentum and killing. And it's first and 10. Oh, and did he just put on a display there? Touchdown! Don't want to make any mistakes here. Just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. It's good. The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. This guy's a... Oh, man, he just laid the wood on that guy.
Yeah, if you're gonna hit a guy that hard, you should at least kill him. Do him a favor.
Finish him.
And it's first and 10. First down. passing game opens up for them. And that's a hell of a cheap shot. Gotta love it. And it's first and ten. And with another pick, the QB says, I don't know if it's throw in it. Oh, what a great defensive play that was, Bricks. Kind of like your Aunt Bertha. This guy has some big balls. What a hit.
Yeah, she does have a big pair, Grim. You're right.
The offense wants to speed things up, so it signals a hurry up.
Same as Bricks' ex-girlfriend signaled when they were doing it.
Yeah, she called it.
Oh, and that's how you play defense. Well, of course, he could have had an interception, returned it for a touchdown, and changed the entire game, but I don't want to nitpick. Oh, that's a vicious hit, and the crowd loves it.
He just turned that guy into 300 pounds.
The defense calls their first timeout to save some clock.
I save clocks too, Grim. My wife hates them. They take up the whole garage.
Wait, what? You're married?
It's complicated.
No doubt about it, that guy is dead. He says, I'm taking you with me. And like Bricks' balls, he is loose and heading for the end zone. He could go all the way. And the hurry-up offense wears out the defense since they can't rest their players. And it's another pick. And oh, that was a big hit. Hey, Bricks, I bet you took a lot of shots like that over your career.
Let's see. About a quarter after three, Grim. But my watch is a bit slow.
And it's first and ten. For a couple of yards. Oh, holy smokes! He just killed that player with a cheap shot. That's why we love the MFL. At this point, they're gonna have to get the ball back by any means necessary, or wasting two timeouts on the defense is really gonna bite them in the ass. And that'll be second and eight to go. Say goodnight to that guy, Bricks.
Goodnight to that guy, Bricks.
You're an idiot.
And the offense has only two running backs left, and the defense is licking their lips.
I think they want to eat those last two runners for this outcome.
The defense lost another linebacker on that play, and only two remain on their roster. Their defense is getting very close to forfeiting this game. The quarterback shifts gears and goes into his hurry-up offense. Second down, and they take their last time out.
It's between them and the clock now, Grim.
Well, and the defense, too. The offense goes into their two-minute drill.
What the hell is that?
It's the same thing as a hurry-up offense, you moron.
He picks up 9 yards on that catch.
Hey, you see that move, baby? No, you didn't. You know why? I'm too fast for you. I'm the greatest, I tell you.
The offense lost another quarterback on the previous play and have only two left before they have to forfeit.
Yeah, but on the bright side, Grim, they save a ton of money by not having to pay those guys anymore. Other than the funeral expenses, that is.
And that's the end of the second quarter. Someone will need to pull together some bribe money as they head to their lockers. Stay with us for the halftime show, brought to you by our friends at Monsatan Industries. We make genetically altered Frankenfood you'll have fun trying to identify. Welcome back. Hope you enjoyed the carnage during today's halftime show. Obviously, they need to play a lot harder here in the second half to make a game of it.
Or they can start cheating and killing. That's what I do.
Hey, man, you see that? That's right. You can't handle this. You can't handle what I got. Yeah, get the hell out of here, man.
The teams are lined up for the kickoff. He's going to be able to run this one back.
I wonder if the kicker was setting up an easy kill.
Oh, and that one's going to hurt. He may not be able to comprehend math after that hit.
What's math?
Exactly. And it's first and ten. Totally unnecessary. I gotta see that one again.
It was also freaking awesome. I hope they have raincoats in the front row because that was splattering everywhere.
And it's first and ten. He had nowhere to go and got nothing out of it. Second down and ten.
Another hit a man when he's down is just plain lazy. Nice extra effort there.
The Leaveland Burns, as amazing as this may sound, dismantle the opposition and come away with a win by forfeit. They come up big today with a solid win, and the opposition will be licking their wounds on the long plane ride home.
I heard wounds taste just like chicken. Or was it scrambles tomato soup? I forget, but a good scab tastes like bacon. That I know.
A scab lettuce tomato sandwich. Sounds like a picnic. And the MVP is about to inspire us with some words of wisdom.
Yo, man, nobody can touch what I'm on. I take all you mutants out. That's right.
Blitzro with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. and all the folks at Evil SN want to thank you for watching this presentation of the Mutant Football League.
Today's game was brought to you by ComCrack Entertainment. They're not happy until you're not happy.